Hello and welcome. This is Kristen, Science and Engineering Librarian at Miami University Libraries, and this video is about making population pyramids. There's a lot of choices for graph creation these days, but unless a lot of people already have access to Google Sheets and are likely familiar with using it already, that's what we're going to use today. You might be saying, wait, Kristen, I've looked and there isn't an option for population pyramids in Sheets. How are we going to do this? That is true. There's not a preset, but we're not going to be deterred. We're going to do some adjustments to one of the presets and figure it out together. So stay calm. So as we've just alluded to, this isn't as common a graph type as some others. So let's talk for a minute about what they are. As the name implies, they show population, usually on the x-axis, and the ages of the population are on the y-axis. And we can see that in both of the examples here on the screen. For both of them, though, we have males on one side and females on the other. These graphs are usually used for human populations, as is the example here, but we can also use these for animals. So you can see population pyramids in sociology, ecology, education, maybe the health sciences, or even economics could have uses for population pyramids. Okay, one more thing before we dive into the sheets. As we said, there is not a preset option for this. Let's think for a second about another chart that looks kind of like this, bar charts. We've all seen bar charts before, and looking at them side by side with a population pyramid, I mean, they're pretty similar, right? It's just the population pyramid appears to kind of have two of them going on. Completely different information between the two that we have on the screen here, but structurally we have categories and numbers for the categories, and that's what bar charts do. So let's plan on using that as our starting point, and here we go. All right, we are in Google Sheets now. Here is our data, small and manageable for the sake of the demo. This is completely made up data for a Sunday school program who has classes set up by age groups. I have the names of the groups there for clarity, but they won't be in our graph. Then we have the age ranges for the groups and the number of boys and girls in each. We are going to use the raw numbers in our example, but if you want, before starting, you can convert them to percentages and use those numbers. It's your project, so it's your choice on what you want to do. This next step is a little weird, but we need to do this because we need to convince Sheets to make what we want. So we saw that we have sort of a double bar chart going on that kind of mirrors each other, and what we need to do is change either the males or the females to negative numbers. I suggest we copy over our raw data to make the changes and then just rename that as the adjusted data. Okay, so now we have an adjusted data that we can mess with and leave the raw data preserved up above. What we need to do now is make the boys into negative numbers. And this is such a short list, I could just do that by retyping them. But if you have a longer list, which you probably do, then we'll want to use a formula. And this is really easy to do. We're just going to multiply the raw data by -1. So let's do that up in the formula bar. Okay, so all I did was set that cell equal to the raw data multiplied by -1. And then we can just fill these all down, and we are set to go. All right, now we are actually ready to make our graph. So let's highlight everything, including the headers. Remember, we're not going to be using the group here, just the ages and the counts for the boys and the girls. We've got that highlighted. We will go up to Insert and Chart. So Google here tries to guess what you want, and we're going to need to change a couple of things. It doesn't look too bad, but we still are going to need to do some adjustments. So let's go over here to the chart editor at the side and change the chart type to a stacked bar chart. That's this one here. Okay, this is looking pretty good. If your bars are a little skewed, then under stacking, you want to make sure that it's set to standard. Let's see what it looks like if you do none. Then it's a little off. You set it to standard. That should fix it. Okay, let's notice something else here as well. Over at the side, the ages are not in the order that we would like them. We would like the younger kids to be at the bottom and the older kids to be at the top. So we're going to need to reverse that. And we can do that over here in the chart editor as well. We've been in the Setup tab. If we go over to Customize and then under Vertical Axis, then we can check the box to reverse the axis order. And that puts the younger kids at the top and the older kids at the bottom, which is usually how population pyramids are formatted. Okay, just one or two more adjustments, but overall it's looking pretty good. If we notice down here on the y-axis, because we had to change the boys into negative numbers so the chart would appear this way, they're being formatted as negative numbers, which doesn't make any sense because we're not talking about kids that are negative ages. So we can fix this. So now that we've clicked on it in the Customize menu, it changes to the horizontal axis, which is where we want to be. And if we come down to Number Format, there's a lot of choices here. We want to click Other Custom Formats. And they do have some to choose from in here, but what we're going to do is type in our own. So this is the code. I'll read it out for you. It is 0 semicolon brackets black end bracket 0. And this tells it that we want the positive numbers and the negative numbers to look the same. It gives you a little preview here. It also means that we don't want decimal points. Now, for your project, you might want decimal points, and to do that, then you would need to adjust this so that it's 0.0, and then you need to do that at the end as well. And if you want additional decimal points, then you just keep adding zeros. We don't want decimal points in ours, so I'm going to take those out, but that's the code that you would use. And we'll click Apply. This looks much better. It looks like a population pyramid. We just need to change the title here, and then I think that we're all done. Okay, I think that that wraps that up for this video. You can, of course, stylize it however you want to. If you want to change the fonts or the guidelines or the colors or anything like that, you can certainly do that. But this is a great starting place for a population pyramid, which we did without a template. All right, let's wrap up this video. We successfully made at least a first draft of a population pyramid in Sheets, and we didn't even use a preset template. Yay, challenge completed. I hope this was helpful for you and your project. Different versions of the software might mean that some of the features I showed are in different menus or places. You might see other features that weren't on my screen, but hopefully it's not too confusing. Please reach out to the library if you have questions, and thanks again for watching.